What's up? This is Chance Hunter, number 13, shooting guard from Cal Baptist University.
What's going on, Chance? Last time I saw you, you were hooping for LB State. Just tell me a little bit about what drew you to CBU, and describe a favorite memory from Long Beach State. Like, what'd you like about it?
What brought me to CBU was just the player development. In my recruiting process, I just wanted to end up at a place where I could become the best player when it's said and done. And just them talking about the plan that they have for me and for the team, it just felt like it was a perfect fit. And then, of course, the event center was just cherry on the top. My favorite memory, I would say, at Long Beach was just me and the guys when we went to Costa Rica. I say that was just a once-in-a-lifetime trip that I'll probably never forget.
Okay, cool, cool. What have you been up to so far this summer? I know you were at Drew League. I know last basketball season was a little different than most. So what have you been up to this summer?
I've been locked in. I feel like this is probably one of the summers where I just kind of stayed out the way. Coming from Riverside and back to LA just for the Drew League was pretty cool, but that's mostly been it. I've just been trying to just develop as much as I can, work on my body, and just prepare for a great year.
All right, so as you may know, Cade Cunningham, the number one pick out of Oklahoma State this year. I recently read an article from before the draft where he actually wrote down everything he wanted to do throughout his high school career and his college career, like at the beginning of every season. He wrote down, like for example, his sophomore year, he said, number one player in the country. I want to do that. He said McDonald's All-American, go to Montverde. And in due time, everything worked out for him. He also said, he wanted to be the number one overall pick. He wrote that down beforehand. He said 40% from three-point line. He really had all his goals written down, and like he was so very scrupulous with like everything he wanted to do. So with that being said, what are your goals for this year, and what do you hope to accomplish as a member of CBU?
My goals for this year are just the areas of improvement for me. So defense, rebounding, I want to increase. I feel like I'm a pretty good scorer, so I don't really want to focus on scoring. I want to focus on the things that are going to help my team this year. So as far as me getting as many boards as possible, me being in the pass lanes more, and then as far as offense, I do want to improve my shooting even more. I want to be a complete knockdown, so I want to go shoot for the stars. I'm looking at 45-50% from the field when it's said and done.
Okay, great, great. All right, so who do you model your game after in the NBA, if anybody?
I would say James Harden, Michael Beasley, those two, just because I'm a lefty, and just I love their game, especially James, how he just creates moves, and just anything he can do, getting back to that left hand, I feel like that's what I do my best. A lot of guys try to send me right, but as lefties, we still know how to get left at any point in time.
Okay, cool, cool. Who is the best player you've ever played in, and why, regardless of private run, college, high school? Who would you say is the best player, and what made them so good?
Right now, I'm going to say around my age group, I'm going to go with Evan Mobley, just because I had him in a couple of the private runs that I went to. He's just a unicorn. Like, he literally can shoot a three. He can take you one dribble, get to the rim, and dunk on you. He literally has everything that somebody would want, and it's just crazy that he's doing that at 7 foot.
Okay, great, great. What's your favorite move as far as whether you're like in a pick and roll, ISO, what's your favorite move to do?
I would say my go-to would probably either be a hezzy pull or some type of step back.
What are your goals for long term? Not necessarily this season, but even after you're a college player, or say 5 years from now, what would you say your goals are? Where do you want to be?
I want to be somewhere around the sport of basketball, whether it's playing, coaching, training. I just want to stick around the game as long as I can. So hopefully I'm playing. That's my goal, to play as long as I can until my body says it's time to quit. But after that, I want to at least work around kids, developing kids, or doing something around the game that's productive.
Who is your favorite NBA player currently?
I would say James Harden, just because he does a little bit of everything. I fell in love with him scoring, and then just to see his game progress to where he's basically getting a triple-double every game is something I look up to.
Nice, nice. So, do you have a favorite team? If so, who?
I would say wherever he goes, honestly. So I was rocking with Houston, now I'm with the Nets. I enjoy KD as well, so having them both is just, I'm rocking with the Nets right now.
All right, so who do you think is the best player in the NBA?
I'm going to have to go with KD. I wouldn't say Giannis is a close second just because of what he did this past year, but I feel like KD is just all around the most, just he's dominant in the game right now. And it's just, I feel like offensively, nobody can really touch him, and then he just does things on the court that nobody's really doing right now.
Nice, nice. All right, so I'm sure you have heard about a lot of like the offseason moves by different teams. You got Westbrook, AD, and LeBron. You're going to have Kawhi maybe out the whole next season, and there's a lot of good draft picks coming in. So do you have any NBA predictions for 2021? What are you expecting? What do you think is going to happen? What's your gut tell you?
I'm going to tell this first. Nets in five. I don't know who they're going to play, but Nets in five. Rookie of the year is going to be a tough one, but I'm going to have to go with Jalen Green just because I've seen him play. I know he got that dog, and I feel like a lot of players not going to be ready for what he's going to bring to the table. I want to say what else? MVP, I feel like I give it to Luka. I feel like Luka got a lot to prove. He hooped this summer, and I feel like he's going to come back even better as a player.
So what would you say is your favorite sneaker of all time? You could either pick a favorite sneaker to hoop in or a favorite sneaker to wear, like on the day-to-day.
My favorite hoop shoe would probably be the Kobe 4 or 5. I got a pair when I was younger, and I just fell in love with it. And then with Nike remastering it, it's probably the best shoe comfort-wise, grip-wise. And then off the court, I would probably have to say either a pair of Jordan 4s or Yeezy 500s, I would have to say, because those are the shoes where I could just wear with everything. They're comfortable. You can wear them all day, and they just look good with any type of fit you got going on for the day.
Any specific like colorway or just like?
Jordan 4, I would say the breads. That's probably they go with everything and they always look good. And then Yeezys, I have to go with the all black pair. Kind of like my Air Force One, I would say. I'm not too big on Air Force One, so I would say those get the job done when you need to do anything. They're good for everyday wear.
Okay, cool. What's your favorite song that you like to listen to, like before a game or any artist?
I would have to say anybody from Detroit right now. So that's going from Babyface Ray, Rio the Young OG, even a little Yachty because he got his little Detroit tape. So it just depends on what my mood is. But I like a lot of Detroit music just because it's upbeat, kind of aggressive. So it gets you going right before the game, gets you intense and just locked in. Because the music they make is all about business. If you're not on business, it's just not going to work for you. So you just got to be locked in and be ready to go at all times.
All right, so favorite pregame meal?
I would have to say either any type of pasta or Chipotle. That's usually my go-to, something that's not too heavy and can just give me enough energy for the game.
So now I'm going to throw some names at you. Just let me know which player you think is better or which player do you like more in a game situation. So, all right, so first, KD or LeBron?
KD all the way.
Steph Curry or Kyrie?
Oh, that's... I'm going with Curry just because shooting, offense is crazy.
Yeah, okay, all right. Luka or Tatum?
Tatum's my guy. I'm going with Tatum just because, you feel me, he's a bucket.
All right, so Bron or Kobe?
You said Bron or Kobe?
Yeah.
Bean.
All right.
LA kid, Bean, all the way.
All right, so this one is a kind of controversial. I don't understand why, but so would you say Michael Jordan or LeBron all time?
MJ, because I feel like without him being the pioneer for everything, I feel like those guys don't have that. Who are they chasing at that point if MJ isn't there, if Wood isn't there? So I got to go with MJ.
All right, cool. Thanks, man. Anything else you want to say to the people or let them know for the upcoming season?
Just be tuned in, Lancer Nation. We coming for that WAC championship.
All right, you heard it here first. All right, thanks, man.